chaos, devastation. That's called dance floor mercurialization.
And with that sound, you know that it's the stream that the FBI masturbates to regularly. We're talking about hacksradio.com. It's Friday, time for a hacker news update. Sorry to everybody, there was not one out on Wednesday. That's because my efforts were involved with the Save Victoria Op Liberation campaign that was a success. The battle, anyway, for the day was a success. The war is still raging. But Victoria, as of this hour, is safe with her mother in Diamond Ranch Academy. For the meantime, not coming to get her. So that's awesome. If you're on Twitter, look for that tag. Search Save Victoria Op Liberation. Support that. Expect that. And anyway, moving on. Hacker News from thehackernews.com. First up, flame malware, 21st century massive cyber attack on Iran. A massive, highly sophisticated piece of malware has been newly found infecting systems in Iran and elsewhere, and is believed to be part of a well-coordinated, ongoing state-run cyber espionage operation. The Flame computer virus not only stole large quantities of information from various Iranian government agencies, but apparently even disrupted oil exports by shutting down oil terminals, information security firm Symantec Israel said yesterday. This is actually behind, so date on this post, let's see here, when the hell was this out? This is, actually it was yesterday's date, excuse me, so this was just the day before. Iran's National Computer Emergency Response Team Masher said in a statement that the detection and cleanup tool was finished in early May and is now ready for distribution to organizations at risk of infection. Flame was discovered after the UN's International Telecommunications Union asked for help with the security firms to find out what was wiping data from the machines across the Middle East. An investigation uncovered the sophisticated malicious program, which until then had largely evaded detection. The virus is about 20 times the size of Stuxnet. Malware targeted the controls of Iranian nuclear facility. The largest concentration of infected machines is in Iran, followed by Palestinian-controlled West Bank, Sudan, Syria, Lebanon, Saudi Arabia, and Egypt. So, wonderful. Outstanding. Next up, hackers took control of two satellites for a few minutes. This is outstanding news as far as I'm concerned. With all the Planet X fear-mongering going on, it would be nice if Anonymous had control of the satellites and could actually tell us what was going on in space, but that's just my opinion. Anyway, according to a U.S. Report recently claimed that hackers had managed to interfere with two military satellites, but one expert argues the amount of energy required would be too great for ordinary hackers. Ordinary hackers. I don't understand that terminology. Anyway, the hackers took control of the Landsat 7 and Terra AM-1 satellites for a grand total of 12 minutes and 2 minutes, respectively. One might hope that the communication satellite suspended in orbit above the Earth might be one component of the planet's technology infrastructure that is safely out of harm's way, but as satellite communications enthusiast Paul Marsh explained at the London Security B-Sides event in April, that there are reasons to doubt the reports. He spoke about the similar story reported in the late 1990s about hackers supposedly accessing UK military satellite communications network Skynet and nudging one satellite out of sync. Whether Chinese hackers have that capability now is just one more matter of speculation to add to the opaque field of cyber warfare. I do have a question. We're assuming that it's Chinese hackers? Anyway. Moving along, New Jersey mayor, this is outstanding, arrested for hacking recall site. The FBI last week arrested the mayor of the northern New Jersey town of West New York, together with his son, on charges of hacking into a website and a related email account that called for the mayor's recall. Felix Roque, 55, the mayor of West New York, New Jersey, was arrested with his son, Joseph Roque, 22. They were released on a $100,000 personal bond after neither entered a plea. According to the criminal complaint filed against Felix Roque and his son on 2 February 2012, the two men began to conspire to hack into and disable a website called recallroke.com. Joseph Roke then allegedly performed a password reset for the GoDaddy account used to administrator recallroke.com. This allowed him to cancel the domain name and effectively disable the website, the FBI agent said in an affidavit. Well, I don't know if that really qualifies as hacking, but anyway, that's the headline. You can check that out on hackernews.com. Along with this headline, NSA intercepting 1.7 billion American electronic communications daily. How do you like that? Cybersecurity, my balls. Good Lord, since 9/11, the agency has been able to spy on electric communications without the need for court-approved warrants. The group has a large complex in Utah that costs $2 billion and holds the data. By the way, that's the same state, Utah, that Diamond Ranch Academy is located in. Back to the Post. In 2006, the New York Times revealed that the Bush administration was eavesdropping on electric communications of Americans without warrants required by law. The American Civil Liberties Union has created an infographic for mass distribution that shows some crazy figures related to U.S. National Security Agency. 4 years ago, Congress authorized the electronic surveillance of suspected terrorists and foreign agents located outside of the United States with provision that supporters would adequately protect the privacy of Americans. The only positive aspect of the FISA Amendments Act of 2008 was that Congress imposed a 4-year sunset provision on the powers it authorized. That sunset provision is set to expire, and surprise, the Obama administration, just like it did to the Patriot Act, is demanding it be renewed as it is, without a single change or reform. Outstanding. All those bits of information can be found again on thehackernews.com. And this last bit of information here is from theexaminer.com. Anonymous hacks Canadian Grand Prix. Operation Quebec continues. This was on the 31st. Anonymous acting in solidarity with student protests and in opposition to Bill 78 hacks into a Formula One website selling tickets to the Canadian Grand Prix set for June 10th, releasing ticket holder personal information. On May 31st, Anonymous released personal information belonging to Canadian Grand Prix ticket holders, information including ticket holders' names, phone numbers, email address, type of ticket purchased, and amount spent online. The action is a continuation of Operation Quebec. Earlier this week, Anonymous released a YouTube video warning potential Canadian Grand Prix spectators that they were targeting the Formula One race as a part of Operation Quebec. And the link to this post will be below, as well as a link to thehackernews.com. Big shout out and thanks to Hacks Radio, Mr. E, The Fixer, the crew, Pride of Cause, all of y'all. Keep fighting the good fight. Do what you do. I'll see you again on Monday.